This week on Making an Anime, let's give our character some hair. Remember when I said, the better the concept art, the easier the build? Well, this just means we have to explore more in 3D. I got the Anime Hair Maker Addon from the Blender Market. For the few extra dollars, it saved me a lot of time and is super friendly to use. But you can do all of this and follow along using curves and just a few more clicks. These are two really cool channels that I referenced when I wanted to get up to speed on Blender sculpting and hair. Definitely worth a check if you haven't already. After you've set up the add-on, select your mesh, which is another term for object. Hit the N key for the quick menu. Select Anime Hair Maker. Click on Draw Bezier Hair. Start from an angle where you can read the hair silhouette. Now, just draw. This first set of curves that we are drawing is going to contain the larger pieces that define the volume and general silhouette of the hair. Increase the overall hair size here and also change the taper of the root to the tip. Now you can select between the hair shape options based on your design. If you'd like, you can even hit this edit curve shape to make a more specific profile for your guide extrusion. The simpler, the better. Select a point on the curve and use the rotate and scale tools to adjust the hair. Then, play with these handles to get the arc you want on the curve. Now, look at it from different angles to make sure it looks good in 3D space. Let's split the viewport to make the process faster. You can even save this workspace for the future if you want. I got help from this video if you'd like to check them out. All the links from this video will be available in the comments section. To create a new hair strand of this size, you could use the draw tool again, or what I like to do is select the curve and duplicate it by hitting Shift D. I'm only working on this section of the hair for the recording, but work on the overall head all at the same time. Always work in large strokes and decisions before spending a lot of time on smaller, refined tweaks. If you need more or less points to edit, select the points you want to add a vertex between. Then, under the Segments menu, click Subdivide. Or just select a point you want to remove and hit the Delete key. Remember, less is always more. I like to have a maximum of 3 points per curve to adjust the hair shape. 2 points are better if you can manage it. This is looking good. Now let's add a second set of thinner hair. Go to Object Mode, select your mesh, and draw a new curve. This time, reduce the volume and even change the shape if you want. I like the triangular and quad profile. Place them where you want them, i.e. around the larger pieces so that you have hair variation to make it look more natural. I won't get too detailed about creative hair theory because there's so many videos for that, like the ones I shared earlier. But basically, I'm thinking about variation of thickness, length distribution, curve direction, breaking symmetry, and the overall silhouette. One thing that's very important is that the new hairpiece roots feel like they are connected to the scalp and the larger pieces, that they all flow and work together. I'm going to make one last set of curves for the final variation of hair size and repeat the process. You can vary hairs at different depths for different effects. Just be careful of where the root of the hair looks like it's coming from. At some stage, you will get lost in all the points. Luckily, under MISC, there is some great tools. I added these amazing move up and down buttons to my keyboard shortcuts to quickly navigate along curves that I want to edit. If you only want to see the curve you're editing, then click this isolate tool. Then later, you can unhide it like this. Alrighty, I think we're done. We can do a few things from here. Let's just give it a simple diffuse shader, like so. The add-on even allows you to finalize the hair into an object with bones. Or you could convert it into an object to sculpt finer details on. Lots of amazing possibilities. Once you finalize the hair, you can delete everything in the outliner that was generated, other than the curve collections. I just kept it as is, so I can make a final call later. And before you know it, bingo, we have some anime hair. Let's pause here and next week tackle the clothes. As always, if you'd like to follow us on our journey of making our own anime, hit the like, subscribe, and alert buttons, even comment. Feel free to follow us on our other socials, and I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching!